Welcome to It's Your Date with Destiny with Apostle Vivian and Pastor Gemma Duncan of Divine Destiny Worship Center in Diego Martin. For the next 30 minutes, join us as we take you on a journey of maximizing your potential and realizing your goals through Jesus Christ.
Why is it when you need a miracle, it doesn't happen, but when you least expect it, it happens?
You are married. You have challenges in your relationship, but your spouse is unwilling to accede to any counseling. Is divorce an option?
How does a parent handle a promiscuous child?
What are considered the do's and don'ts of a born-again couple who is not yet married?
There are always more questions than answers. So here is Apostle Gemma.
Grace and peace to you. Welcome to Ask Pastor Gemma. And again, we almost can't believe that we are in 2024, but we give God praise for being here. If you were with me last week, I'm sure that you're all fired up and excited to hear part two of preparing for your day of visitation. And that's the message that our eldest son, Donnell, is ministering, and I thought it would have been a very appropriate for the beginning of the year, looking forward to a brand new season. Don't forget that Donnell also released his new book, The Knowledge of the Glory, and it is available on Amazon.com. You can call 633-3780, which is our office, to see if we do still have some copies. Keep in mind that you can get it hardcover, soft copy, as well as an ebook. As I said, this week, we're going to just continue part two of the message that we started last week, preparing for day of visitation. Before I do, let me just fill you in as to what is happening in Divine Destiny Worship Center. In the event that you are a first-timer, my name is Gemma Duncan. My husband and I, Apostle Vivian Duncan, are the pastors of Divine Destiny Worship Center. Our headquarters is in Diego Martin on the Diego Martin Main Road opposite Sardonyx Drive. We have branches in Sangre Grande in Chaguanas, one in Faisabad, there's a branch in Tobago, and one branch on the island of Antigua. Our regularly scheduled services, Sunday mornings at 9 a.m., live and online in every branch. Thursdays at 7 p.m., we have what we call School of Intercession with Apostle Vivian Duncan, where he's actually teaching on intercession. And the amazing thing is his emphasis is on the intercessor, more than the actual intercession. And God has had him there for about a year, just dealing with the intercessor. On Fridays at 7 p.m. online, for now, we have a Friday service. But
there will be a live service on January 26th at Diego Martin. That's a Friday. And in all branches, it will also be streamed online.
Our office hours, Monday to Thursday, from 10 a.m. to 3 p.m. and the business center will be open Monday to Friday from 9 a.m. to 3 p.m. As we speak, we're right in the middle of the official launch of Bethel House of Praise. From the 12th to 14th, we all will be in New Jersey. All roads will lead to New Jersey, where officially we will be supporting Dion, anointing him and his wife Leah, and believing God for an impact in that community. It's a brand new area. There is no full gospel church of that manner around, and it's a pioneering work for Dion and Leah. So we solicit your prayers. Feel free to join Dion and Leah every Wednesday for an online Bible study. And you can get the information YouTube at BHOWNG Livestream. YouTube at BHOWNG Livestream. Anything you missed and any information you want, you can call us in Diego Martin 633-3780 for any additional information that you may want. Just to let you know, School of the Bible Registration closes January 31st, 2024. If you miss the train by January 31st, you have to wait until 2025. Registration has been opened since July. And so jump on the train, call us 633-3780 or SOTB at ddwc.net. SOTB at ddwc.net and be a part of School of the Bible for 2024. Sit back, relax, and take in this next installment of preparing for a day of visitation.
All I can hear God saying is everybody has their day. The challenge is everybody's not always ready for their day. Because the day has nothing to do with the person. The day has to do with God. So he has already determined ahead of time that everybody's going to get their day. But the only thing you have power over is what you do when your day comes or whether or not you recognize it. Because the people in Jerusalem did not recognize their day. So you might think you ain't never had your day, but you just may not have recognized it. Because the people in Jerusalem didn't recognize their day had come. They're still looking for the day, and the day came and went. And God says some of us aren't ready for our day, because when the day comes, we can't even recognize what it looks like. Matthew 25, verses 1 to 13, New King James Version. Matthew 25, verses 1 to 13, New King James Version. Then the kingdom of heaven shall be likened to 10 virgins who took their lamps and went out to meet the bridegroom. Now 5 of them were wise and 5 were foolish. Those who were foolish took their lamps and took no oil with them. But the wise took oil in their vessels with their lamps. But while the bridegroom was delayed, they all slumbered and slept. And at midnight a cry was heard, "Behold, the bridegroom is coming, go out to meet him." Then all those virgins arose and trimmed their lamps. And the foolish said to the wise, "Give us some of your oil, for our lamps are going out." But the wise answered, saying, "No, lest there should not be enough for us and you. But go rather to those who sell and buy for yourselves." And while they went to buy, the bridegroom came, and those who were ready went in with him to the wedding. And those who were ready went in with him to the wedding. One more time. And those who were ready went in with him to the wedding. And the door was shut. Afterward, the other virgins came also saying, "Lord, Lord, open to us." But he answered and said, "Assuredly, I say to you, I do not know you. Watch therefore, for you know neither the day nor the hour in which the Son of Man is coming." And the Lord keeps saying, I need you to be ready for your day. Ready for your moment. Ready for your opportunity. And the word the Lord gave me today, sitting here in the church, was your day of visitation is upon you. That which has been prophesied is upon you. That which you have expected, you knew would come at some point in your life, some point in your ministry, some point in your story, it is upon you. Do not miss it. Recognize it. And one of the things the Lord was saying, speaking from the parable of the 5 foolish virgins and the 5 wise virgins, is that people miss their day of visitation because it takes a long time to come. The 5 virgins were only foolish for one reason. They weren't prepared for the long haul. Had their day of visitation come quickly, they would have been ready. However, the bridegroom took a while. So because they didn't have extra oil, they could not last until he showed up. One of the main reasons why people miss their moment is that they lack endurance and run out of steam or oil early. I've heard this preached specific to the oil. What the Lord was telling me today was, yes, it's about the oil, but it's not really about the oil. It's about the fact that they did not prepare for the long haul. It just happens that they had a lamp that required oil. And they didn't have extra oil so they can last long enough until their moment comes. So what the Lord was saying to me was, many of us have to understand that built into the model of our days of visitation is that it's going to take a while. It doesn't happen quickly. And because of that, we got to set things up in a way that is sustainable. Set things up in a way that you can keep doing this for a long time until your moment comes. What do I mean by that? If I know it's going to take a while for God to show up in the way he promised, then I have to ensure that the way I set up the ministry, set up what we're doing, it is sustainable. We can do this day in, day out for years and never stop until the day he shows up. Why? Because you don't set it up in a way where you can't make it that long because it's unsustainable. The way you set stuff up cannot be maintained. It's the same thing with our lives. Like God says, whatever I have planned for each of you, you have to find a way to function in a sustainable fashion that you could maintain whatever I have called you to do for a long time until you get your breakthrough. Never live a life where you're one step away from burnout, one step away from giving up because you did not think, I gotta be able to do this for years. I remember when we were early in this ministry, we were trying to do too much. Why? Because we came from ministries that were doing a lot, but we didn't have people to do all of that stuff. So who was doing it? Apostle Angel and I. And when you start doing too much, you start getting to the point where what you're doing is unsustainable, which means you're not going to last long enough for the day to come for the Lord to show up with your day of visitation. You're not going to have that opportunity because you're going to burn out. You're going to burn out. You're going to burn too much oil too fast. It's during that season of my life I got a good understanding of what it means to burn the candle on both ends. When you're burning from both ends, you're burning too fast. It's a whole concept of how can I make my life, my business, my ministry, my career, whatever I'm doing, sustainable. Where I'm doing enough to keep moving forward, but I'm not doing too much that I get burnt out before I get my breakthrough. Because your breakthrough is not something that's in your control. Your control, the only thing you can control is being ready for when God shows up. But you need to be there. You don't want to have given up by the time he showed up. Because there's that moment coming when the supernatural is going to show up in your business, in your ministry, in your house, in your career. Your breakthrough moment is coming. But you got to be there long enough. So they planned for the long haul. So they brought extra oil. Versus, we carry just enough oil with the expectation that God's about to do it now, which is intense, because I want to live a life where I believe God's about to do it now. He's about to answer my prayer now. But the truth is, some stuff it don't happen quick. It just doesn't. And I love a fast word. I love a word that says it's happening fast. I always love those words. Somebody come to me and say, brother, it's about to happen for you tomorrow. I was like, amen, brother. Why? Because I want that. I want, tell me that I'm about to get all my prayers answered, all my breakthrough tomorrow. Tell me, brother, before you go to bed, it's gonna happen. I was like, amen. Why? Because I like that. Because who's trying to wait? Who's trying to last long? We ain't bring no extra oil, so we need this to happen fast, because we're not going to make it if it doesn't happen fast. And God says, only the foolish don't prepare for the long haul. I said, God says, only the foolish don't prepare for the long haul. I'll say it one more time. God says, only the foolish don't prepare for the long haul. they think it's about to happen now. So they live and they function and they set things up. They structure their business, structure their ministry, structure their career, structure their lives in such a way that if they don't get the breakthrough now, they're going to run out of steam. They're going to burn out all of their oil. They're not going to endure. So it's a mindset change. One must pace oneself. If I'm going outside and I'm going to run 4 miles, I'm going to run 4 miles with a very different pace from when I'm running 1 mile, with a very different pace from when I'm running 100 meters, because I need to last till the end. Now, professionals, they can go out there and sprint a marathon. That's on them. The rest of us, we got to jog a marathon. We don't run marathons. We jog marathons. You see what I'm saying? We get out there and we take our time and relax because we're trying to finish. We're trying to win no prize. All we want is a free t-shirt at the end because we finish. Or whenever they give everybody a medal like kids, everybody wins a medal. I like that. 5 foolish virgins missed their day because they did not prepare for the long haul. And God says, y'all will get your opportunity, but you got to be there when it happens. And you got to be ready for things to take a long time. So don't grow weary. Endure. Don't grow weary. Endure. Galatians 6 verse 9. Galatians chapter 6 verse 9. Let's read that together in the Amplified after 3. 2. 3. Let us not grow weary or become discouraged in doing good. For at the proper time we will reap if we do not give in. I can't set things up in such a way that I can't last. Where I get so tired because I'm not pacing myself that I give in. God's like, you got to be sure you're thinking long. Always think long. What if this takes really long? What if this takes really long? Let me get a long lease. Because this may take a long time. It may not happen next year. Let me get a long lease. And let me make sure the price is something that I could sustain. If you're going to learn anything from me, I'll teach you. Don't put yourself in a situation where if things don't happen fast, you're done. Don't go sign something where you know when you do the math in your head, the bills are so big that your breakthrough must happen now for you to pay those bills. Don't go sign a contract where if you get your breakthrough, it's going to work out. But if you don't, you're not going to be able to make those numbers. You got to think ahead of time. What if this takes a long time? What if I don't turn a profit until 3-4 years down the road? What if this takes a long time? Am I going to be able to maintain this? Because I know my day is coming, but I need to be able to do this long enough for my day to come. I don't want to leave. I don't want to give up. I don't want to fall apart. I don't want to run out of money. I don't want to run out of steam or oil before my day. Because as God says, everybody's going to get their day. Everybody's going to get their day. But like Jerusalem, you have to recognize it. And like the wise virgins, you have to be ready for the long haul. You're going to be able to recognize your day. Because that's what Jerusalem did not do when Jesus came. And you're going to be able to last long enough, which means you have to set things up in a sustainable way. Prepare yourself for it to take long. It's supposed to take long. Now, the truth is, God may show up tomorrow. But you are not living like he's showing up tomorrow. You're living like it's going to take a long time. And then you're pleasantly surprised when it happens quickly. But you're not planning for it to happen quickly. You would love for it to happen quickly, but you're preparing to last a long time. Hey, I'm going to take my time until I get my breakthrough, until I get my chance. You see what I'm saying? I was like, I'm going to take my time until somebody buy that album. I'm going to take my time until I got the promotion, until whatever. I'm not planning for something to happen for me tomorrow. I don't know when that's going to happen. I don't know when I'm going to get the raise, so I'm not going to sign a lease on an apartment that's so expensive that it's dependent on the raise that I'm guaranteed I'm getting this year. I don't know. What if I don't get it this year? What if it takes me 5 years? I got to make sure those numbers make sense. How am I putting oil aside so I can last? What am I thinking if this takes a long time for me to get my breakthrough? Our day of visitation doesn't always come quickly, but it always comes. If we can last long enough, we will be ready to benefit when it does happen. Don't stop doing what God says to do before you get what God said you will have. So whatever good you're doing, don't get yourself burnt out because you're doing too much too quickly. Take your time. Pace yourself. Do enough. Make sure the math makes sense. I mean, young people come to us and be like, boy, you should go in and pay, buy this fancy thing, and you should move into this fancy. I was like, we're not spending unsustainable money with the expectation that we're going to get our breakthrough to pay it. That don't make any sense. We're like, that we got to be able to last. Because what if the breakthrough doesn't happen this year? What if it doesn't happen next month? How am I setting up my situation that I can last long enough until I get my breakthrough? But then there was a man who kept missing his moments. A man who had days and times of visitation over and over and over and over, and he kept missing them. It's one thing to miss it once, it's another thing to keep missing it over and over. John chapter 5, verses 1 to 9 in the Amplified. John chapter 5, verses 1 to 9 in the Amplified. Let's read that together after 3, 2, 3. Later on, there was a Jewish feast festival, and Jesus went up to Jerusalem. Now in Jerusalem, near the sheep gate, there is a pool, which is called in Hebrew, Jewish Aramaic, Bethesda, having five porticos, alcoves, colonnades. In these porticos lay a great number of people who were sick, blind, lame, withered, waiting for the stirring of the water. An angel of the Lord went down into the pool at appointed seasons and stirred up the water. The first one to go in after the water was stirred was healed of his disease. There was a certain man there who had been ill for 38 years. When Jesus noticed him lying there helpless, knowing that he had been in that condition a long time, he said to him, "Do you want to get well?" The invalid answered, "Sir, I have no one to put me in the pool when the water is stirred up. And while I am coming to get into it myself, someone else steps down ahead of me." Jesus said to him, "Get up, pick up your pallet and walk." Immediately the man was healed and recovered his strength and picked up his pallet and walked. Every time the angel stirred the water was an opportunity for healing. Yet the man missed his opportunity to be healed repeatedly because nobody helped him. Because only the first person into the water got healed, people were probably focused on getting in the water themselves or helping their loved ones. Then Jesus showed up. Ladies and gentlemen, the first thing I said was, people miss their day of visitation because they don't recognize it. Jerusalem didn't recognize that when Jesus was there, that was their time. When somebody said, "Now is your time," that was their time. So people miss their day of visitation because they don't recognize when that day comes. The second thing we talked about was people miss their day of visitation because they didn't prepare for it to take a long time to come. So they didn't set up their lives in a sustainable manner so they can do whatever God says to do repeatedly, consistently, for as long as they had to until they got the breakthrough. They didn't come with extra oil. They weren't ready to keep doing this for years and years and years before their day came. They came with the assumption it was going to happen fast. They came with the assumption that I'm going to start that business this year, and by the end of the year, I'm making millions. They made an assumption. So the rent was too high. The place they rented out, they didn't think, what if it takes a while? They didn't think. They went and hired people, and now they can't pay no salaries. They didn't think. They quit their job, and now they're doing the stuff part-time and thinking that was going to be enough, and then the sales started to slow down. They didn't think I have to plan and prepare and set up my situation that I can last long.
Then Moses said, "Please, show me your glory." Exodus chapter 33 verse 18 in the Amplified Bible. In the spring of 2022, after 2 years of the COVID-19 pandemic, God said that it was time for His church to begin preparing for the next great awakening. He said that what was coming next was a manifestation of His glory on a level that our generation had never seen before. While we have no quantitative means to prove the full extent of this, we believe that many Christians across the globe have also been looking forward to this unprecedented outpouring of the Holy Spirit. Some call it revival fire, while others call it a sovereign move of God. Some call it a shift in the Spirit, or any other number of titles. Nevertheless, we're all in some way or another referring to the same thing. God's presence will be manifested on the earth in such a remarkable fashion that it will forever change the trajectory of the Church of Jesus Christ first, and then the world. This book, Knowledge of the Glory, Preparing for the Next Great Awakening by author Donald Duncan, is a prophetic message from God to help His church prepare for it. Available in paperback, hardcover, and ebook formats. Pick up your copy today at Amazon.com or any major online bookseller.
Again, you were inspired. I want you to know that every single one of us, as Donald would have said, has our day of visitation. Some people, it's a corporate day for a group of people. Some persons and almost all of us will have our individual day of visitation. And each of us need to be prepared. We don't want that day to pass like the five foolish virgins and we miss our day of visitation. God bless you real good. Don't forget what Jesus said. He said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man comes to the Father except by me."